the Hallpike test. This is also known as the Dix-Hallpike test, the Nylan-Baranyi test. They all mean the same thing. Okay, this confirms the diagnosis. And what we're looking here is not just reproduction of the symptoms, but we're also looking for nystagmus. This is an illustration, so I'm testing the patient's right side. She's sitting far enough back in the gurney so that when I lie down, the head is overhanging the edge of the gurney. So the particles start here, and they move to the newest dependent portion. Okay, so why do we turn the head 45 degrees to the right in the Hallpike test? So this is my hula hoop analogy again. And let's see. So these are my posterior semicircular canals. These here are my attempt to represent the otoliths. Okay? So when you're doing the Hallpike test, you're trying to figure out, are these otoliths in the posterior canal? So you actually want to make them move. And the most provocative way to make them move is to first line the canal up in the same plane as you're going to move the patient, because that's the most provocative way to move the particles. So what I mean by that, again, this is my right posterior canal. It's oriented 45 degrees. This is my left one. If I'm testing my right side, I turn my head 45 degrees to the right. I've now aligned this canal, and I'm going to lie back. And if there's particles there, they're going to move. And they're going to flash, too, I guess. This one didn't move. Does that make sense to everybody? So you first, if I'm testing the left side, I turn my head 45 degrees to the left, I lie down, and there's particles, they're going to move. Okay? Because some people want to lie down first and turn their head. You can do that, but you're more likely to get a false negative, because that's not as provocative as first lining the canal up, then lying back. Okay, so this is a video clip of doing a Hallpike test. So I'm testing the right side. Notice I'm sitting her far enough back in the gurney where the head's going to overhang the edge of the gurney. 45 degrees first, then lie back. And even though you tell them to keep their eyes open, they're going to want to shut it. So I often use my thumb just to keep it open, because it's important to see the nystagmus. Okay, then it usually resolves once those particles settle. Then you sit them back up. And I usually test both sides. Okay, so what are we looking for on the Hallpike test? Well, aside from reproduction of the symptoms, you're looking for nystagmus. Okay, if you remember from medical school, nystagmus is described in the direction of the fast phase. And what we're looking for is a mixed or torsional or rotatory nystagmus, one that's not purely vertical, one that's not purely horizontal. It's kind of a mix of the two. And this, again, there's usually a few seconds latency as it takes time for those particles to move. It usually lasts only 10 to 20 seconds, sometimes up to a minute. You get reproduction of the symptoms, and it's often reversed when you sit them back up.